Okay, whenever you're ready.
All right, well, the working title for my game so far is Don't Be Dinner. And it's going to be built to win on Android. It'll be, the target audience is age 12 plus because they can't have humanoid NPCs. The setting is at a seemingly paradise island. The team is a first person wave attack. Basically a 3D version of Metal Slug is something I'm aiming for. The environment is in the Pacific Ocean, an island, which is inhabited by cannibals. The gameplay is going to be manic, fast, pace shooter, wave attack, and a survival. The mechanics are jump attack, pick up ammo on the field. Like I said, target audience determined by the humanoid enemies. The two devices I have access to are a Nexus 7 and a Galaxy S6. So I'll test on the Nexus 7, which was built and released in 2014, and then the game should run on most modern tablets. The schedule so far, the way I see it is we have 11 weeks left, so I've broken it down into 1 week chunks, even 5 weeks to do the characters, the animation, the texturing. Then I'm going to implement the acid spring and particle systems and implement the scoring system. And then hopefully, with the work I already have completed, that'll leave an extra week for testing, but I'll have a minimum of a week. The story is, you play as Private Bean, an Air Force chopper pilot stationed in the Pacific Islands on a routine mission flying ammo to an outpost. He was caught in a storm and unfortunately had to ditch the chopper. Floating on an ammo crate for 2 days, he eventually watches onto a beach, and he must search you on it for food before he starves. Then he can worry about getting rescued. The resource budget, the tests I've done so far, the models have a maximum 2.5k birds, so that will allow me to have 50 on screen comfortably, hopefully, which will aid the manic style. Then I'll have 55 left for level furniture, and basically the level is just going to be a big island, so it shouldn't take up that much. The textures are going to be 2048 with 2048. I have a tuning style, so I don't need them to be any bigger. And I will try and implement the water texture. I know the basic version runs on Android, but I'll have to test the advanced version. And so some of the influences on the art style are Boom Beach. I wanted to try and keep the colours bright and appealing. And these are some of the models I've made so far. It's basically a palm tree I've made. See how low we can keep the birds. It has 84 birds. And a low poly volcano. Just level furniture. These are some of the huts I've modelled and how they look in Unity. I have a problem with the back face colour that I have to sort out. And that's some of the real world references and what I looked, you know, again. So character concept, and these are just some basic sketches I've done just to get an idea of the kind of characters I might have. I decided in the end that I'll go with a Boom Beach kind of army soldier guy. I'll use a native cannibal and a shaman. And these are just simple models I've tested so far to see how they look in the Unity. And I haven't textured them properly, I quickly painted them just to test out the style. Okay, so I've sculpted a normal map onto them to bring into Unity to see how it looks. And these are the references. I thought these would be packed full of characters, so I'm going to use them for the enemy. And that's it. Comparables, I suppose, are Metal Slug. That's about it.
Thank you. Right, what's the food you're going to be searching for? What's the, you know, how does the game play? Like, how much food do you have to get, or how do you get off the island, or what it's just, how do you survive?
Basically, just, I'm going to have it, so the shamans are walking around and they're spawning these huts, and then the hut spawns a load of enemies out of it. So I was thinking that maybe the food, maybe your hunger has gone down, which is your life, and then there's animals running around the island that you have to shoot and collect. collect that. That way then the cannibals are collect, taking up the food that you have to try and get, and then at the same time they're attacking you. They're going to attack you with some kind of range, hopefully spears and blowpipes or something, which are taken away from your energy all the time.
It reminds me a bit of remember the game from last year, Green Topics.
Yeah.
Something similar where he did create some animals, but he didn't have to go, you'd have to make as many models you're going to have to make. You've already made the start there, but his was more like toads and it was going to wild boar and stuff.
Yeah.
Things running around the place, a poisonous toad and all.
The idea I was thinking was, I've done simple models and I was thinking of maybe modelling a mask that I could alter in some way and then just using the same model stick different masks on that will be.
That would be great. Yeah, great idea, yeah. Okay, there's still a lot in that. Like, so, and again, but what's the point of the game then? So what do I have to do? I've got to fight off these cannibals, but then what? You know, maybe do I have to kill, or do I have to, or have, you know?
Most of the games that I've made so far, I don't have a main goal at the end.
Yeah,
so I want
to be the prototype, is it?
Yeah, this I want to, I'm going to like, track score heavily, and I'm going to track the field and the health. I'm going to make them dominant on the screen, so it's obvious what the aim is,
yeah.
And then it's basically just get your score as high as you can and last as long as you can.
Okay.